thing that he's sort of uncovered that other economists are quite excited about is, for many years we've sort of assumed if you let the market be the market, things will continue to improve for everybody. And what he's revealed is, in fact, one of the functions of capitalism might be inequality. In fact, left to its own devices without some kind of tethering forces, taxation or other policies, growing inequality is a function of pure capitalism.
So there's a reason that France is losing all of its wealthy people, its successful entrepreneurs, its captains of industry, because that kind of thinking is insane. So already France has attempted to raise, has attempted to raise taxes on the wealthy, including their property taxes, to 78%.
Yeah, but you just heard he said he doesn't believe in property taxes.
It doesn't matter. He's got a progressive tax on the rest of your wealth, including all of your cash if you had it in cash.
Right.
So what's happened in France is they are losing their future. Everybody that has money in France that knows how to build a business has left the place because of that kind of thinking.
Hold on a second.
Is that going to work? Absolutely
start,
not.
Just start with the
and
basic.
It's interesting that you write a book, and I'm sure you sold a lot of copies, but we tried that in Russia, and it doesn't work.
It's a book that economists have hailed as seminal, game-changing, and the thing that these...
Well, I'm telling you, no discussion because it's a crazy idea. Insane.
So a book that has garnered worldwide attention and accolades merits no
discussion.
No,
I'm talking about
view.
The part where he
Kevin
says,
O'Leary,
let's redistribute
because you
the
don't
wealth.
Like how it sounds?
Redistribution of wealth doesn't work. We tried it in the Soviet Union, North Korea.
Hold on.
Would you like to live there? How about Cuba?
The premise of the book is very simple. It's that when return on capital is higher than the growth of the economy,
what's wrong with that?
Inequality ensues.
That's a derivative of capitalism.
Well,
so what?
Well, because societies have discovered that at certain levels, gross inequality is actually bad for the economy, and it's bad for the vast
Amanda,
majority of people.
Take it to an extreme.
So the answer,
why would I work if you could guarantee me I'd have the same money as everybody else?
He's not a communist.
That's what you just said.
No.
You want everybody, no inequality. So I don't have to work.
No, some amount of inequality is healthy and necessary.
Okay, so are you
going to
decide what
that
should be? Are you going to decide what the ratio is going to be?
Well,
you're
yes.
going to decide?
Yes, in the same way that
and
collectively we've decided on
Who
tax
decide?
Levels and policies. We collectively, as urbane and thoughtful, educated people
When you have progressive taxes, you punitize, you put penalties on success. Why would you want to do that?
The only way to reverse this problem, that the rate of capital grows faster, and incidentally, he also revealed that the bigger the capital pool, the higher the return. So once you have a lot of money, you make ever more of it.
Oh, that's horrible.
Well,
what an awful outcome.
What happens,
my goodness, we should put those people in jail.
Because
they're successful entrepreneurs. They deserve to be jailed.
To starve the economy of growth.
Oh, imagine people getting rich from working hard. That would be a horrible place.
He also raises that you'd be interested. You should read this book. Take it to the cottage this summer. He raises the point that in the U.S., the 1% are from this new class of super managers, people who are just paid excessive amounts.
And we should punish them for their success.
And first of all, there's no evidence that being paid that much makes their performance better. And secondly,
is it capital punishment we should bring in? Should we kill them?
There's a one-to-one correlation between lowering the top marginal tax rates and their salaries going up.
Okay, let me explain what this idea has no merit.
You can say that inequality doesn't matter, but everybody else in the world thinks it does.
Some of the greatest services that you use every day, and I'm going to take an example. Google, which was started by a couple of starving students who are immensely wealthy now. You want to steal their money for their success?
Nobody wants to steal their money.
That's what you just said.
And we, in fact, need that kind of innovation on entrepreneurship.
But you don't want them to make any money.
Kevin, there's no... first of all, these debates would go better if people like you didn't get so upset about it.
I'm very upset.
Nobody's trying to steal anyone or kill anyone. And in fact... most of us actually really believe in wealth and entrepreneurship.
No, but you said you need to limit it. There should be a cap on it.
What you need to do is make sure it's being shared. Make sure it's being shared.
People should be allowed to make so much, and then everything else should be taken from them.
That the Google founders did it in isolation, and guess what? They didn't.
So
there is a society that backs all of you up.
I am going to try and convince as many people before I die to fight this evil that you're even... putting out here, and frankly, thank goodness I'm here to debate it with you.
I find it very exciting, actually, that this book is getting the traction that it is. You should read it before and understand it before you get too
worked up. I understand it completely. I've seen this model.
But guys like you don't do your cause any good by acting like this is an outlandish idea that inequality is bad.
I spend my whole day defending capitalism and all the merits it brings
society. This isn't about being anti-capitalist. That's a straw man argument.
You are against success, and you want to penalize success.
No, that's not true.
And I think it's outrageous.
I'm against selfishness.
And you want to steal money from wealthy people that are successful.
And lies.
No, you are. You've got a big problem. And thank you.